Hi folks, we're here today to share with you the Word of God. It says Psalm 34 verse 18, the Lord is nigh unto them that are broken heart and have such to be of contrite spirit. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart and save such as of contrite spirit. It says the Lord is near to the broken hearted. That we have to have a broken heart, that we have to be sorry for the things that we've done wrong. So he says, the Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart and save us such of a contrite spirit. That we have to be broken for what mistakes that we've done. That if we come before God and say, Lord, I'm sorry for what I've done wrong, He will comfort you, He will bless you, He will forgive you. The Lord is nigh unto them that have a broken heart and save us such of a contrite spirit. That if we have a humble heart and we have a humble heart and that we seek God in humility, and if we are broken and feel broken for the mistakes that we have made, then Christ will forgive us. Seek the Lord while He may be found. Call upon Him while He is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord, and He will have mercy on him, and to our God, for He will abundantly pardon. Isaiah 55, 6 and 7. But he says, seek the Lord while He may be found. Seek the Lord while He may be found. That we have to seek God while He may be found. You might not find Him tomorrow. You might die and go to hell. So you've got to seek Him while you can now. Call upon Him. Not only are we to seek Him, but we are to call upon Him. We are to call upon God. You can never find God unless you call upon Him. Call upon Him. While He is near, God is near to you right now. God is near to you right now and wants to meet with you right now. Let the wicked forsake his way. 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 That we've got to forsake the way. We've got to move away from that which is wrong. Let the wicked forsake his way. If we're lying, we've got to forsake it. If we're stealing, we've got to forsake it. If we're sleeping around, we've got to forsake it. If we're in idolatry, worshipping anything but the living God, we have to forsake Him. If we're cursing the name of God, we've got to forsake Him. Let the wicked forsake his way. We've got to forsake the ways that are wrong. If we don't forsake the way that is wrong, then we are declared wicked before God. If we are stealing, if we are gambling, if we are getting drunk, if we are taking drugs, let the wicked forsake his way. Don't be wicked. Don't glory in that which is evil. Don't glory in that which God says is sin. Let the wicked forsake his way. Let the wicked forsake his way. We have to forsake that which is wrong. We have to turn away from that which is wrong. Let the wicked forsake his way. And the unrighteous man, his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord. And the unrighteous man, his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord. It is not only the things that we do, but it's even our own thoughts. That God wants us to turn away from things that are evil, even in our thought minds. Even in our minds, our wrong thoughts. We have to turn away. Hey, Pete, all right? We have to turn away from wrong thoughts. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Forsake the evil thoughts. The evil thoughts of anger. The evil thoughts of hatred. The evil thoughts of adultery. Let us forsake them and leave them. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Evil thoughts we have to leave behind. Evil thoughts of hatred or anger. Evil thoughts of adultery. Evil thoughts of stealing. Evil thoughts of lying. Not only forsake our way in our actions, but also forsake our evil thoughts. Let him return to the Lord. Let him return to the Lord. Let him return to the Lord. Let him return to the Lord who will grant you mercies. The Lord who will grant you forgiveness. The Lord who will grant you his mercy and kindness. Let him return to the Lord, and he will have mercy on him. And he will have mercy on him. He will have mercy on him. He will have mercy upon the person, the person who turns away from the wicked things. He will have mercy upon the person who trusts in the Lord. He will have mercy on he who gets rid of dirty thoughts, wicked thoughts, evil thoughts, as we forsake the wicked thoughts. As we forsake the wicked thoughts, and as we forsake the wicked way, and we go to the Lord, he'll be merciful. He'll be merciful. The Lord is merciful. The Lord is kind. The Lord is gracious. And the Lord will forgive us.
Send it.
The Lord is merciful. Let him return to the Lord, and he will have mercy on him. God will have mercy upon you. God will shower his grace upon you. He'll shower his love upon you. He'll shower his kindness upon you. He'll shower all his mercy and love upon you. But you've got to forsake the evil way. You've got to forsake the evil thoughts. You've got to return unto your Lord, and you've got to seek him. And as you seek him, he will shower upon you his mercy. And he will have mercy on him to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. He